Today we're going to take a look at OBS versus XSplit Broadcaster. As you know, OBS is free. XSplit Broadcaster costs $200. So I really want OBS to be the better of the two. And what we're going to do to determine which is better, primarily looking for audio video sync under heavy load. So in order to give the computer a heavy load, we're going to render this video clip and convert some raw files to JPEGs and just see which one performs better. Leave a comment down below and let me know which one you think is the better of the two. Here we are testing OBS. I'm going to go ahead and run those tests that we talked about. And what you're looking for here is to see if the audio video stays in sync, especially with the webcam. Here we go. Let's go ahead and convert these raw files to JPEGs. And while that's happening, we'll convert that intro. So what you're looking for here is to see if my audio video stays in sync. It's not going to take too long to complete this, so I'll keep talking throughout. I noticed in the past when I did this kind of test, well, not really a test, but just when I was recording a tutorial, that the audio video, especially under heavy load, would go out of sync, or sometimes the audio would drop. I noticed that specifically in XSplit Broadcaster. So again, what you're looking for here is to see, does my mouth line up to the audio? Is there any drop frames? How's this looking? Now, I'm just going to keep talking because we've got another 55% to get this done. So let's try something like this. I'm going to clap and see if the audio stays in sync. How about now? Is it still in sync? What about now? What if I switch to the camera? What if I switch back to the camera and me? Still in sync. How's it looking? Testing 1, 2, 3. Back to the face cam. Back to just me. Testing 1, 2, 3. Is everything in sync? Well, this is almost done. Let's go ahead and boot up XSplit Broadcaster and see if that's in sync too. Very good. Last test. Am I in sync now that the recording has completed? Am I still in sync? Okay, now off to XSplit. For real this time. Here with the XSplit Broadcaster. Let's test it out. We'll do the same test as before and just see what happens. Okay, first we're going to go ahead and start the conversion of the raw files to JPEGs. Then we'll go to Adobe Resolve and start the render. Now, this is actually the second time I'm running this test. The first time I ran it, I had an experimental audio feature on by accident, and I also had it set to force the frames per second. So this time I turned that off and I disabled the experimental audio. I think that'll improve things, because before, when there was a heavy load, the audio would kind of start to miss and be kind of a popping sound. So we'll see if this is better. The first test I ran, the audio and video did stay more in sync than it did with OBS, especially when I did a test like this. That should seem more in sync. So far, XSplit's the way to go, but one thing I don't like about XSplit Broadcaster versus OBS, OBS can do two separate audio tracks, whereas XSplit Broadcaster cannot. It has to be one audio track. So, pros, cons, but anyway, let me know what you think of this. Is XSplit Broadcaster more in sync? Does it look better than OBS? Or does OBS look better than XSplit? So here we are again. Am I in sync with this? Or is this in sync? Again, this is XSplit Broadcaster. Thanks for watching.